there is no international mechanism to address problems of misappropriation of our intellectual property rights or our cultural property. And because apart from the larger question of how to prevent conversion, there is also the very specific question of what do you do with those aspects of your, it's called TKE, traditional knowledge expressions. That's the word that is used for each of these things in the legal parlance. Okay.
Traditional
knowledge expressions.
TKE. Okay.
TKE. Okay. So whether it is basmati or whether it is anything that we associate with our way of life, every tangible and intangible expression of your way of life is treated as part of your cultural property.
Correct.
So there is a larger discourse or a legal framework that the world has been discussing for several years. Now, it so happens that India is perhaps uniquely placed to bring to this particular discussion the blunt perspective that while you wish to protect the products of this way of life, somehow you're running away from protecting the way of life itself.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is as good as saying that I will protect the medicine that comes out of a tree, but I will not protect the tree itself. Okay. So therefore, we are trying to say, recognize the fact that your civilizing, colonializing, evangelizing tendency and the ongoing efforts of missionary groups across the world, especially in Bharat, which has become a battleground for their harvests, their soul harvesting activity, is the single biggest reason of forcing several groups to abandon their ways of life and in fact adopt a certain consciousness that not only alienates them but puts them at a diametrically opposite position to their erstwhile identity. And if, and to put it in the words of both Dr. Ambedkar as well as Swami Vivekananda, every Hindu less is one enemy more, is more or less how it has become.